There are several popular financial incentives for commercial solar, and one of them is solar depreciation. If you've come to learn about this coveted solar installation tax benefit, stay tuned, because today I'm covering how depreciation works for solar installations and how you can start reaping the benefits. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Eric, and this is Going Solar with Pivot Energy, where we cover all things solar energy, commercial solar, solar financial incentives, and community solar. If you want to take advantage of the financial benefits of solar energy, you need to understand all of the available incentives first. So let's dive right in. One of the biggest financial incentives for commercial solar in the US right now is the Federal Investment Tax Credit, or ITC for short. It's monetized based on a percentage of the total amount invested in a solar project, meaning it lowers your business's overall federal tax liability by the value of the tax credit. For the remainder of 2022, the ITC is set at 26%, but the tax credit rate is currently slated to step down to 22% at the beginning of 2023. If you want to learn more about the ITC and some of its time-sensitive benefits, check out our video, Why You Should Act on 2022 Solar Incentives Today. It's linked in the description below, along with the other videos I'll be mentioning today. There are also state-level benefits across the country. For example, at the time of this video, California has fruitful net metering policies, and Illinois has a program where utilities financially incentivize companies to produce solar energy. Since we're mainly covering depreciation today, our video, Solar Financial Incentives, goes over all of the state and federal tax incentives. So be sure to check it out to learn more about the benefits that may be available to you. Also, don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you never miss when we post. All right, now let's get to the benefit everyone's waiting for, solar depreciation. If you need a quick refresher, depreciation is just a term that represents the declining value of an asset over time. A business expense like a company car, equipment, or in this case, solar panels, can be written off on your taxes as an annual expense. So for example, if a business owner like you buys something that lasts for more than a year, like solar panels, you are likely eligible for depreciation. But how does that work? When you invest in a solar energy system for your company, you have the option to depreciate the system on your taxes, and you can do this in addition to claiming the federal ITC. Accelerated depreciation, aka the Modified Accelerated Cost Recovery System, or MACRS for short, is a method of depreciation where asset value reduces at a faster rate early on. In other words, the depreciation is sped up or accelerated. It lets business owners, like you, depreciate the total cost of your solar installation from your taxes for 5 years instead of the 25 to 30 years that the system will be in operation. That means you are creating tax losses in those 5 years that will reduce your taxable income and thereby taxes paid during the early years of your solar project's operation, increasing the project's profitability. Thanks to rising electricity rates and the decreasing cost of solar installations, the return on investment for a solar system is going faster and faster. So overall, you can save a lot of money. Since accelerated depreciation is combined with the ITC though, the depreciable basis, or the value of the system eligible for depreciation in the first year, is reduced by half of the ITC percentage. This all may be a bit confusing. So here's an example to illustrate the benefits of the investment tax credit and depreciation. Let's assume you start your project in 2022, so you get to claim 26% value for the tax credit upon completion of the project. Then, say your solar project costs $1 million to build. Since the ITC is 26%, your tax liability is reduced by $260,000, meaning the $1 million project value is now $740,000 net, assuming you have sufficient tax liability to be able to claim the entire ITC in year one. Now, let's incorporate depreciation. The depreciable basis is reduced by half the ITC rate. So, if you start your project in 2022 at a 26% ITC, half of that is 13%. That means you can depreciate 87% of the total cost of your solar panels. When you crunch the numbers using an assumed 21% federal corporate income tax rate, that comes out to around $182,700 in depreciable value. There is also bonus depreciation, which is another type of accelerated depreciation. It was passed in 2010 to help stimulate the economy following the economic downturn in 2008, and it lets businesses claim 100% of the depreciable value in the first year an asset is in use, instead of having to depreciate over the five-year MACRS schedule. If you go that route and incorporate the tax benefits of the ITC and depreciation, the system you purchased for $1 million really cost you a net of $557,300, or 55% of the total cost of the system. That means the initial shock of the solar installation expense is buffered in the first year by the tax benefits, which is incredibly helpful for business owners making new purchases. Plus, if you can't claim the federal tax credit, you can depreciate 100% of the total cost in the first year. How cool is that? If taking advantage of solar financial incentives like the ITC and depreciation sounds exciting to you, and you're ready to get started with your own commercial solar project, Pivot Energy can help. At Pivot, we walk you through every step of the process so that you can fully understand all of the financial benefits. We have years of experience that helps us guide our clients through the commercial solar financing process. That said, we are solar pros, not tax pros, so it's always a good idea to consult with your accountant or tax advisor regarding the ITC and depreciation. If you want to learn more about what it's like to work with us and the expected timeline, check out our video, What to Expect with Commercial Solar Developer, Pivot Energy. And remember, all of the videos I mentioned today are in the description below. If you now understand how solar depreciation works, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notification bell so that you get notified when we post new videos. If you're interested in learning more about how your business can get started with commercial solar this year, or even just learning more about financial incentives, leave a comment down below or head to pivotenergy.net. You can also reach out to me directly using my email listed in the description, and my team of solar experts and I will get right back to you. Thanks so much for tuning in to Going Solar with Pivot Energy, and we'll see you next time.